Hey guys, so currently in our case type, we are using two data pages to source data from our data types. This is fine, but in the last video, we discussed how we are using a decision table to set the room rate based on the selected room type. This is not scalable. Imagine each time that we want to add or update new records, we will need to update our decision table as well. Instead, what we want to do is to use a data object. This data object will store all the information based on the selected record from the drop-down field. In this video, that's exactly what we are going to do. We are going to create two data objects, one for a hotel and the other for a room. Let's begin. So, creating data objects in App Studio is quite simple. First, let's go to our case type. We are going to start by creating our rooms data object. So let's go to Select Room step. Click on Configure View. And let's create a new field. In type, we have three main options for creating data objects. We have data reference, embedded data, and queries. Okay, so what is the difference between these three? Well, embedded data is for when users need to enter data into the case type. So let's say, for example, that you want to enter a new room type, so you will need to provide a type, a room rate, and the max guests for that room. Data reference has two main things, has a source from the database, and you also have an option to include a dropdown. So this is when you want to fetch information from a data type. For example, let's say that the user selects the suite room type, so we can have all of the attributes of this room type. So we have the type, the rate, and the max guests. And query is exactly the same, but here we don't have the drop-down option. So when we are using query, we must provide the primary key to fetch information. In this first example, I'm going to use data reference for a room object. You can name your data object anything you want. I'm going to name it room page. In the data object dropdown, select the room data page. In options, leave single record checked. And in advanced, you can leave it as it is. Now click on submit.
So we can see now that we have our room page data object. And it has many fields. We can see here that the type is data relationship. In options, we have right now read only. Our data page is room, and it comes with a view. And we can create a new view, or we can create a default view. So I'm going to create a default view because I want it to be named default. And I'm going to go over here in the gear button and I'm going to add a drop down. So we have two options. We have drop down list or search box. For this one, I want it to be a drop down and I want them to select the type of room. And now in options, I want this to be a required field. So this is going to be very similar to what we had before. So let's click Submit. And save and run. So now we can see that we have a data object which comes with a view. Here we can select the type of room and the information is automatically populated. It's very similar to what we had here, but the difference is that these two fields are not related, but all of this is related. So if we change this, everything is on the room page. So the type is on the room page, the max guest is on the room page, and the rate is also on the room page. We don't need any decision table for this. So what I want to do is to remove these two, and I'm also going to change the labels for this view. So now I have updated these values, but I also want to update this one. Now I want to do the same, but for our hotel. This time I'm going to use query. For this, it's also going to be single record. The data page is going to be our hotel data page. And for this, we have the option to give a primary key. So if we know the name of the hotel, we can enter here the name of the hotel. Or we could also use an existing field that has that primary key. In this case, the select hotel has our primary key. So I'm going to choose a field and I'm going to search for the select hotel. Here, I'm also going to create a default view. And if we click here, we can see that we don't have any available configurations. So I'm going to click Submit and let's save and run it. Okay. Let's test this. If I select this one, I should have all of the information for this selected hotel. The reason why it is not showing is because we need to refresh every time that we select and obtain from here. So I'm going to click on Configure View, and we are going to add an action set to this field. So when we click that Edit button, we are going to see this section where we can add action sets. I'm going to click here, create an action set. The event is going to be a change event, and the action is going to be a refresh action. So let's click OK. Let's click Apply. And let's see if this works. Yeah, it works. So I'm going to move this to be below the select tail. So now it looks like this. I want to remove the title. So now it looks like this. And we can see that in this last view, some of our fields are not configured correctly. This is because this one was from the previous field that we just deleted, and these two, and our total, which should be 700, is also not configured correctly. So I'm going to update the room type and the room rate. So our room type, this is the property that we were using before, but now we have a room page which contains the type of room. So now we can use that one. I want the label to be room type. The same with the room rate. And for our total, if you remember, we have a declared expression that multiplies the stay duration times the room rate. And to configure this, we need to do this in DevStudio. So let's go to DevStudio. In DevStudio, let's go to our App Explorer. Let's expand reservation, which is our case type. And under decisions, we have our declare expressions. So our declare expression is for our total field. So here we need to configure this expression. So instead of room rate, I want it to be room page dot rate. So now I'm going to go back and return. And we can see that this was configured correctly. So that's pretty much it for this video. We have been working a lot in App Studio, but something that you will notice when you start working is that you will be most likely working in DevStudio. So in the next videos, I want to explore DevStudio. I think we will start working there a lot. And I want to add new things to this application. So see you in the next video.